Well, Stuart and Teresa, do you feel all shook up?
We do indeed.
Great. Well, this is a good time to be that way because this is a serious moment, isn't it? Mm-hmm. Something today is going to change. God is connecting you two because he tells us in his holy word what love is. That love is patient. Love is kind. Love is gentle. Love is joy. Love is peace and happiness. Love endures. And love will never fail you.
Charlotte, do you think this devalues a marriage because it's a sort of instant marriage?
What's most important, Francis, to me, is that people love each other.
Have you ever thought of how many people you married?
Well, I think it's been around 800,000, maybe 900.
800,000 people in this chapel by you or one of your colleagues. You run a very big business here.
Well,
I mean, it's 40,000 weddings a year.
God can do anything if you let him.
That must be a $4 million business, which is a decent-sized business.
It's not about money, it's about love. Yeah. It's about love.
Money not come into it somewhere down the line?
Well, I think we could get along without with a lot less money, and I think we could get along with a lot more love.
If you will place this ring upon her left hand... With this ring?
With this ring?
I thee wed.
I thee wed.
I give you all of my heart.
I give you all of my heart.
You are my best friend.
You are my best friend.
You are my husband.
You are my husband.
You are my everything.
You are my everything.
I love you. You are legally married, husband and wife. You may kiss your bride.
Yeah, I know it's kitsch, I know the word taste doesn't even appear, but you think of it just like being a normal little church or little chapel, and which is what it says it is, but it's not. But they believe it is, and I think they are sincere. I mean, but then I have to put that out of my brain and sort of try and wipe that away and say, don't be such a bloody idiot, Fulford. It's a superb act. I go away still thinking this is a bloody business. You know, somebody's doing very nicely out of it. But also thinking that it fulfilled a need. And maybe that's not a bad thing. But I'm bloody mixed up about the whole thing, I admit. I'm one mixed up kid. Okay, maybe rhinestones and plastic don't do any real harm. But it's still superficial to me. It makes me wonder what deeper values this country still holds dear. Americans talk proudly about freedom. Their belief that democracy rests on the right to freedom of speech. But how free are they? This is, after all, the country which invented political correctness. And suing people has become a national pastime. I'm about to meet someone who'd be punished for the things he says. He's what's called a shock jock. And like me, has a reputation for being rude. Okay, Bubba. Is it Bubba or Blubber?
It's Bubba.
Not
is it
Blubber.
Francis or Faggot? Which one is it?
Well, funny enough, a faggot in England is something you eat. I know a faggot in America is something you do something to.
Well, a faggot in America is somebody who has bushy-ass eyebrows and bad teeth.
Faggot in England is called a puff, and a puff tends to wear a gold necklace.
Francis, we have these things in America called salons, and it's where you can get your nails done and your eyebrows waxed. I might want to take you there tomorrow.
I don't believe you go to a place like that.
Oh, bullshit. Look on. You want to see my toes, how good they look? I have good toes. I'm pretty well cultured.
You do. You genuinely go to have a manicure.
I'm tan. Look how tan. I shave my arms. I mean, look at those toenails, Francis. This toenail right here could be used as a fucking weapon. I wouldn't believe you could get on the airplane with those fucking things. And they think in England that you're good looking. You're a sex symbol in England?
No. I never said I was a sex symbol in England.
I'm glad you didn't, because you have been fucking lying.
You know, I understand you're a bit of a rebel, right?
Yeah.
I understand that you've almost had more jobs than me. You've been sacked from, what is it, 8, 9 radio stations?
12.
12? So why has suddenly your audience been denied you? Why have you been sacked?
Well, we have this political arm of our government called the FCC, and they regulate the public airwaves. And they find, after 3 years of listening to my show, 27 different instances that I was deemed offensive or indecent. And it all totaled up to $755,000 fine. And as you guys would say, I got sacked.
What are the things which really get the guys up in Washington? What can't you say?
What can't I say in America?
Yeah.
I don't know.
Well, you must have been saying a lot of the things you can't say to get chucked off the radio.
The rules state that if it's offensive or deemed objectionable by community standards.
That's quite a broad...
Why don't you tell me what the fuck that means?
Well, I don't know what the fuck that means.
That's what I'm saying.
How can they say we've got freedom of speech?
We don't. We don't have freedom of speech. We do not have freedom of speech in this country.
So your freedom of speech is only as per some faceless bureaucrat or committee in Washington deems it to be.
As much as I hate to agree with you, Francis, I agree with you.
I want to find out if Bubba is right to think the freedom of speech is under threat.
Can I ask you a question, please?
Are you American?
No, we're not.
No speak English?
No, sorry. Okay.
Thank you.
You don't speak English? Of course, it's a melting pot, America, so you expect that. The trouble is, most of the people I speak to haven't yet melted. Are you American?
I'm American, of course.
I see you got an American flag here.
Well, of course. I'm a veteran.
Perfect. How do you feel about our freedom of speech, and do you think that right's being taken away from us?
Yes, I feel very outraged that it has been taken away. You got the right to say, but you better say what you're supposed to say.
Can't say the word God. God forbid if you say God. If you show this on TV, I'm probably going to get in trouble.
Do you feel that we're still the land of the free and the home of the brave?
Legislation is continually taking it away. I really believe that.
What's the most politically incorrect thing you can say?
Bush is an asshole.
What's that say again?
Bush is an asshole.
You're not gonna go there?
I'm not gonna go there. We used to be able to say we don't agree with that, but now you say fuck the police or something like that.
You get put up against the wall.
Oh man, you're getting laid out. Fuck you against the wall.
What would get you in most trouble?
The most trouble? Anything religious.
Anything religious?
Yes. Or maybe the F word.
But or maybe the F. Great.
Thank you.
If they don't have freedom of speech anymore, where are this country's roots? I want to find the Americans who think the past still matters.
I fell into a burning ring of fire. I went down, 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 and the flames went higher. And it burns, 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 the ring of fire, the ring of fire, the ring of fire, the ring of fire.
One of you boys riding?
Yes, sir.
Both. You are both of you. How do you get on?
I won first place.
Can't do better than that, can you?
No.
The fact you're both cowboys, you walk a bit taller.
Yes, sir. Oh, yes. We don't put on a costume. It's just about being a man and being tough. I guess we all got something to prove being tougher than the next one.
What makes you boys feel proud to be an American?
The most important thing was the independent spirit, the self-sufficiency, but more important than that to any of us is the liberty.
Do you think you still got the same freedoms today that you might have had 40 years ago?
Only on the back of a horse.
Do you feel you belong to an old America under threat?
Very definitely. I think we've become spoiled.
Yeah.
We've become wealthy. The worst enemy this country has is American wealth. It's a hedonistic, self-centered culture that cares about me and me only without any kind of responsibility. My understanding of the future of this country depends upon the resurrection of that cowboy spirit, the frontier spirit that established the country.